Hi everyone, welcome. My name is Andreas Watts, and in this Shopify Brooklyn theme tutorial, part number 9, we're gonna learn how you can customize the rest in your Brooklyn theme. All right, so let's go to part number 9. Okay, so in this Shopify Brooklyn theme tutorial, part number 9, we're gonna customize the rest of the theme. All right, so to do this, just click on Customize Theme. Okay, so first we have this one, rich text. So if you want, you can talk about your brand and add a text. So just click on rich text, add a heading. And add a text about your business. Okay, so you can just make some improvements here with the bold, italic, and you can add a link as well. Just highlight the text, click on link, and link to products, or paste the URL right here. Okay, then you can change size. Okay, I want to have medium, show wide display, like that, or non-wide, like that. I think this looks much better. Then click on save. Okay, so let's go back. Now we can add featured collection right here. I have added some extra products in this shop, so just click on featured collection. You can change the heading if you like, then click on select collection. I'm gonna choose kitchen tools, then click on select. Okay, so now we have featured collection right here. If you want to change this layout, you can just click on grid style. So we got college. We can also choose grid. Then it's gonna look like this. Feature collection with the products in the grid, like this. Okay. When you're satisfied, just click on save. Then go back. Then we have a newsletter, this one. Click on that. You can change the text, the heading, the subheading. So here you can add an offer or things like that if they sign up for a newsletter. All right. So any customers who sign up will have an account created for them in Shopify. Then you can view customers right here. If you don't want to have this one, you can just click on remove section. Otherwise, click on save and then go back. You can also add sections, then click on add section. So here we have a blog post, we got the collection list, featured collection, image with text, feature products, newsletter sign up. If you want, you can add a map. And here you can add heading, your address and hours, your map address, and map link label, show pin, yes or no. Then we have background. If you want to have a map right here, you have to go and register a Google Maps API key. So just click here and enter the API key right here. Or you can just choose an image to have in the background. So let's click on image. This is just an example. So you can have any image you like. All right. So you can also choose explore free images. Okay, so something like that. Just choose an image you want to have. All right, then you can choose image position, top left, top center, and so on. Just play around. When you're satisfied, just click on save. Okay, go back. Then we can add section one more time. We also have the rich text, video. So you can add a special video. Just click on, just change the heading and add a video link from YouTube or Vimeo. So let's go to YouTube. Click on the video, pause the video, click on share, then copy the link, go back, and just paste it right here. Okay, so you can have whatever video you want to have in your store. Then click on save, go back. Okay, so then we can click on footer. So here you can edit the menu. Click on edit menu. If you want to have more menu items in your footer, so let's click on add menu item. Click on link, choose maybe collections. Can add a tag if you want. Okay, then click on add. Just add all the pages or collections, products you want to have in the footer menu. Okay, so then click on save menu. Then we can go back. Click on themes, customize, go down. Now we have search, contact us, bakeware, kitchen tools. All right. Then we have sidebar menu. Click on that. You will see the sidebar menu right here. So if you have more than five pages right here, this will create a sidebar menu instead. All right. So here you can delete the footer menu if you like that, and you can edit menu here as well, and you can also enable search like that. So when you are satisfied, just click on save, go back. Okay, so now we can go and change theme settings. So we can click on colors. So here you can change all the colors on your Shopify store. So let's say you want to change this subscribe button. Just find it right here. So this is buttons. Just click on the color. Now you can change the color to whatever you like. Okay. So I want to have this red. All right. You can also change links. Form, fields, background, headings. So just play around until you get the perfect color combination. Then click on save. Go back. Then we have typography. So this is just fonts, sizes, and things like that. Just play around. And then click on save, go back. Cart page. Okay, so I'm gonna add one of these in the cart. Like that. Okay, so this mode is called drawer. This will end up right here. If you change to page and click on add to cart, you will have this mode. So you can choose if you want to have the drawer or page. Okay, so I want to have page. You can also enable order notes. So if your customers want to add a special instruction for the seller, so this is good to have also, I think. Then click on save. Then go back. Then we have social media. So you can add an image. So if someone shares your products, this will include this image as well. So I'm just gonna click on learn more. So this will add an image for the product they are sharing, like this. So you can just add an image, whatever you like. Then we have social media accounts. Just add a link to your profile. I'm just gonna do this to show you how it's gonna look. Okay. So now you can see in the footer we got Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Instagram, and YouTube. So just add all the links to your profiles. So when they click on this one, this will take them to your profile. Alright, so then go down to sharing options. Share on Facebook, yes or no. Tweet on Twitter, yes or no. Pin on Pinterest, yes or no. Okay, then click on save and go back. Then we got favicon. So this is the small image you see right here. So this is good to have to brand yourself. So just click on select image, find the image you want to have. Click on select. So this will be scaled down to 32 times 32 pixels. Then click on save. Go back. So let's go and have a look at the favicon. Let's go to store. Okay, so now we have the favicon right here. Okay, so let's go back and customize. Then we have checkout. Okay, so if you go to checkout, so this is the page we can customize in here, the checkout. So we can add a background image. I'm just gonna show you examples. Okay, so this will change the background right here. Then we have logo image. This will add the logo right here at the top. We can also edit this logo. We can change position, center. And also the size. Like that. Then we have a main content area, background image. We can change color or add an image in the background right here. Like that. I think you should have white. Okay, you can also change the color. Like that. I want to have white. And you can change form fields from white to transparent. I want to have white. Order summary, this one. Background image. Like that. I want to have white background color also. Typography heading. You can change the fonts right here. Body, same thing right here. Colors, links, highlights, and check marks. Buttons, errors. If you want to change buttons, just click on a color like that. Okay, so when you are satisfied, just click on save. Let's go back. Go to sections. Okay, so now we have customized all the things we can customize in our Shopify store. So we have added the rich text. We have a collection list, featured collection with products. We got a newsletter sign up. We got the background with opening hours and things like that, the address. We added a video. And we added some extra collection in the footer, in the menu, and also some social media accounts. Okay, everyone, so this is the end of part number 9, how to customize your Brooklyn theme. Let's go to part number 10. Okay, everyone, so I hope you now have an awesome customized Brooklyn theme in your Shopify store. If you want, you can leave a comment. You can also subscribe to my channel right here. All right, so let's go to part number 10. Just click on this image. All right, so I hope you have an awesome day. Take care and bye.